Now I know why Bon Jovi plays everything a couple of keys down. So, that brings us to the last song on what I'm doing, and yes, I got one more song because this is for visual effect. Believe me, at my age, this isn't going to turn anybody on. But it's all for working on. The path that Chris has taken in this paranormal industry with his own personal experience, my similar path is with music. And I don't know if you're big band fans, but yeah. About 10 years ago, I followed my gut. I put together a promotion for the 40th anniversary of the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show. And I had put the music away in my life for my first marriage, and that didn't work out. I mean, I had three beautiful kids, but I wasn't really allowed to be a musician. But then I actually applied what I learned at Geneseo, and I married a Geneseo girl the second time around, and she's all about music, and we've never had a fight in the 10 years we've been together, so that works out. But she's also a Badfinger fan, and it works out that the radio station I worked for at the time did this event, and Joey Holland is the last member of Badfinger alive. And so I had a Beatle band called the Fab Five, and it was had been around for a few years. But again, I had just gotten into it at 39, and so we back up Joey, and we got along famously. And he said, you know, hey, you know, if you want to work together, let me know. And so, short story long, is that I'm now his official promotions person, and I get to play with him in Badfinger when he needs me, and we have this cool two-person storyteller show that talks about, he does all the storytelling, and I play guitar and piano for him. Well, one night, about 2 years ago, I'm watching the finale of Breaking Bad, like so many millions were, and all of a sudden, at the very end, they started playing Baby Blue, and if you know that song, it's Guess I Got What I Deserve, perfect for Walter White, and Baby Blue is the color of the crystal meth that he made. Now, that's not a spoiler alert, but come on, you read about that, do you? But I'm sitting there drinking my wine, my glass of wine, I just spit it out when it came out. I called Joey, who lives in Minnesota. He didn't know about it. He didn't write the song, so he didn't have to know about it. But because I do his promotions, my emails and my Facebooks, it's just everybody wanted interviews with Joey once they Googled our website and saw he was the only one alive. So Entertainment Tonight, Inside Edition, NBC, ABC, Hollywood, Rolling Stone, all those, you know, so it was like I was in the game, you know, it was like I was in the game. It was really cool. And then from my friendship with Joey, he took me to Australia for 3 weeks for a tour. We went with Terry Sylvester, the Hollies. And since then, I've worked with people like Ambrosia and the Rascals and Tom Rundgren and Alan Parsons and all these heroes of mine, John Entwistle of The Who, all because of Joey and his friendship. So this is the parallel that Chris and I have had. So this is why he invited me to play tonight. So thank you, Chris. Love you, man. Appreciate it. So instead of singing Baby Blue, I'm gonna knock down the old gray wall and do the big hit.
Thank you.
Chris. Bill.
That was awesome.
One more round of applause. Please Talk With Me, the film. Right outside the door, there are various gift baskets out there that are being raffled. You can check that out and also sign up for the Ghost Watch for later tonight. Take a quick bathroom break and be back here in 5 minutes at the start of the film.
With that story, they were thinking of, oh, that was my technique as an actor.
they weren't thinking of that. So we all kind of had our little sorority there on set, and we really did. And we've all kept in touch over the years. And to make a long story short, I think I would just kind of like to sum it up. Our lesson in humanity from this film, excuse me, it kind of touches me in a way. And faith in human spirit, I have found, is a quote by the great J.R.R. Tolkien. And to learn from Chris and from the great John Jeff. Moonlight drowns out all but the brightest stars. And Chris and John and Mara and Linda and the character Lucy and every single person who I have met on set. Every single one of them who I keep in touch with to this day. Thank you all so much for bringing my life to a greater purpose. Moonlight drowns out all but the brightest stars.
Okay, can we have everybody take their seats, please? Announce the roundtable discussion, and this is really kind of cool because it's the first time that so many of the witnesses to the haunting are actually